Penn State researchers have focused on developing an innovative low-temperature sintering technique to enable the discovery of new materials. A professor and his team are advancing research on the cold sintering process.
So sintering is an important manufacturing process whereby powder is consolidated in by a pressure and then ultimately then shaped into a body and then taken to a thermal process whereby then thermal diffusional processes then drive a densification and grain growth process. In contrast, cold sintering uses a transient phase that then drives dissolution and precipitation, also under very moderate temperatures, maybe 200 degrees, and moderate pressures, maybe 100 megapascals, to then drive a body to that densification. So vastly different temperatures are being observed, and hence cold sintering.
Sintering generally requires high temperatures of around 70% of the material's melting temperature to drive diffusional processes in order to densify the material. But the cold sintering process only takes up to 20% to highly densify the material. What is the underlying science that drives this process? A postdoctoral scholar is focusing on understanding its mechanochemical reactions, which resemble natural rock formations.
Cold sintering is a geologically inspired process, mainly based upon pressure solution creep, which occurs by serial dissolution, mass transport, and precipitation processes following chemical potential gradients between high and low stress areas. In structural geology and diagenesis, this chemomechanical process provides a physical background to explain several phenomena such as lithification or other deformation features observed in stylolites, calitic, and other sedimentary rocks in the upper crust of our planet, which is located 10 kilometers under our feet.
As the working temperature of the cold sintering process is significantly lowered, it can reduce the energy needed for producing a sintered body. What are the unique technological opportunities that the cold sintering process can offer? A doctoral candidate is working on the co-processing of ceramic polymer composite designs.
One of the unique technological advantages of cold sintering process is the densification of ceramics at very low temperatures, typically under 300 Celsius. This brings up a lot of opportunities. For example, the co-processing of different materials into multi-layered devices or the design of novel composites, which permits the integration of a broad set of material classes and functions. An important feature about these low temperatures is that they limit the chemical reactions of unwanted secondary phases, which could hinder the functional properties and the densification of our material.
The applications of the cold sintering process are not limited to engineering new electroceramic designs. A team of researchers in architectural engineering is utilizing the low working temperature to produce low-carbon building bricks. A professor demonstrates how the cold sintering process can play a significant role in making sustainable building materials.
Cold sintering can address the problem of carbon emissions associated with the production of fired bricks. We have developed concepts at the laboratory scale that demonstrate that the cold sintering approach can reduce the high temperatures associated with firing bricks. We are currently exploring the possibilities of making cold sintered bricks using mining wastes.
The technological and environmental values of the cold sintering process are highlighted among diverse scientific communities for various applications. Its unique low temperature process is opening new opportunities for sustainable manufacturing.